Welcome. So you've pressed play on the headstand tutorial. So first and foremost, it's important if you have any high blood pressure issues at all, then you don't want to be turning yourself upside down. Remember, this pose actually can be performed for up to 20 minutes for some people, 30 minutes. So it actually, the pose gives you energy. And it's great for relieving stress and that sort of thing. So one of my faves, but again, we don't teach this very often in classes because most people aren't ready physically, mentally is another thing altogether, ready physically to really approach the pose safely. So let's first work with the hands. And when we move into a headstand, with the support of the hands, we're actually using the forearms, okay? This part of the arm and the hands are grounded down into the earth, okay? So let me just show you that from the side. This part's here. So we interlace the fingers. The last, final little pinky there, I like to tuck him in side so he's protected. And then you want to draw those elbows in line with the shoulders, in line with the shoulders. Too often I see people with their elbows out wide, okay? So you can see that's not really a great place to practice. We want to draw everything confined, and so then we can use the muscles through the back here to drop these down. Okay, so let me show you from the back. In here, drop shoulders away. Good. So that's your grip. A lot of this is coming from the core and the strength through the shoulders as the forearms press into the floor. Okay, so we want to make sure we're not sort of sinking too much. So good prep poses are your chaturangas and your dolphins. Let me show you. So you know your chaturanga practice. Inhale, exhale, execute. Okay, so anything like that is building strength in the arms and the core. The other one to set up for is dolphin. So see, I'm bringing my hips over my knees. Elbows beneath shoulders. Fingers interlace. Pinky comes underneath. Crown of the head to the floor. Here I am stable. Tuck the toes under and lift. Most of us will stay here, okay? If you want to add on, you can start to walk the feet. And you'll notice if you're doing this with me, you're already building strength by doing this in the core and in the arms. So I'm pressing the forearms into the floor. And then a pike. That's when we bring the knees in toward us. So a few things to note there is when my legs went up toward the sky, my toes were active. I hope you saw that. So the toes are active. When I came back out, I piked in again. Yeah, that piking, that bringing both knees in towards you first. All right, what you didn't see me do was throw a leg up, yeah, and potentially injure my spine or my shoulders. Same thing when I was coming out, I didn't just flop out of the pose. So it was slow and it was confined and it was challenging because it was actually practiced correctly. So it's really important that you do that. You'll know when it's time to come out. You'll feel it in your breath when it's time to release. And so you'll come down slowly. Please don't kick the feet back down. And always after any inversion, take child's pose. Namaste.